I'm Connor Coley. I'm a new assistant professor in the Department of Chemical Engineering, and the focus of my research is to bring new computational tools to accelerate the discovery of new molecules and materials. One of the projects that we're working on at the moment is applying Bayesian optimization to the selection of optimal molecules. So trying to discover a new functional molecule is a very challenging process, partially because there are so many molecules to choose from. So there are an estimated 10 to the 20 or 10 to the 60 small molecules that are biologically relevant, depending on who you ask. And of those, we've only really synthesized and tested a very small amount, maybe 10 to the 9th. And so this is a very complex search process for which we need some tools to help us identify most efficiently what the best molecules are for a given task. And so the group has been working on computational techniques to learn to correlate molecular structures with their function to speed up this process. You can imagine that if we have a way of simulating the properties of a molecule computationally, or a way of running an experiment to test the properties, that can be quite expensive, especially if we're thinking about testing hundreds, thousands, or even millions of different molecular structures. One of the techniques that we've been applying recently is model-guided optimization, where we train machine learning models to essentially replace these expensive evaluations. And so if we train a machine learning model to recapitulate what an experimental assay would find out, or what an expensive simulation would find out, we can use that to screen a large number of molecules in a much more efficient amount of time. By going through iterative cycles of testing molecules, training machine learning models, and then predicting which molecules should be the most performant, we've managed to speed up the identification of high-performing molecules by orders of magnitude. So the applications we're interested in sort of span many different disciplines, from drug discovery to material science. And what we're trying to do is essentially think about figuring out which molecules are going to have the best biological activities, the best physical properties, maybe bioavailability, right? There's so many different aspects of a molecule's function that help influence whether it'll be a good drug candidate, for example. We're relying on these computational tools to help us understand the function of these molecules across a number of different dimensions. And the different applications I talked about, so drug discovery or material science or, you know, agriculture even, they're very similar in how you approach the discovered molecules. So the process one undertakes looks quite similar for these different applications, even if the details of what makes it a good molecule change between them. So a lot of the techniques that we're developing are trying to make the process of discovering new drugs or new drug candidates faster and cheaper. So we have access to a lot of these computational tools and simulation tools that help us predict molecular properties. There are techniques like docking, molecular dynamics, but efficiently using these tools is still a challenge, again, because we are dealing with such a large search space of candidate structures. And so these new tools are going to help us accelerate the rate at which we find high-performing compounds and reduce the computational cost. And so overall, that's going to shorten, hopefully, the development timelines when bringing a drug from an initial early stage all the way through to clinical trials. We're really after shortening and accelerating that part of the drug discovery process.